over a period of time since the government of India has come into power, some honorable governors during the past 2 years till date, right from Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur, Goa, Meghalaya, did not work according to the rule of law, did not took decision according to the Constitution of India, violated the democratic norms of this country, and appointed the leaders and the chief ministers of the Bharatiya Janata Party ruling party, flouting all the norms. Coming back to Karnataka, immediately after the elections were being held, no political party could get the required number to form the government. The Bharatiya Janata Party had the single largest party. But meanwhile, the number two and number three political parties, that is Congress, 178 members, JDS 138, two independents, 78 Congress, 38 JDS and two independents. So the put together the number was 117. We immediately got together and met Honorable Governor. Not only once, we met him thrice. And here in Karnataka, we took lead. We met Honorable Governor twice to stake the claim much before the BJP leadership stake the claim. We had presumed that in Manipur, Goa and Meghalaya, the central government and the governors of those respective states had changed the rules of the game. Then no single largest party will form the government if the other parties, 2, 3, 4 together have the majority, they can form the government. This was the new rule set up by the Bharatiya Janata government, Bharatiya Janata Party government in Goa, Manipur and Meghalaya. So going by that rule, everybody thought, the entire country thought, the same rule which the BJP government has made for these respective three states will apply in the state of Karnataka. So we were waiting that Honorable Governor will invite us. We gave the list of 117 MLAs, that this is the breakup. You call us today, right now, we'll prove the majority. But the BJP does not have more than 104. So you cannot call them. But unfortunately, to the surprise of the entire nation, the BJP invited, the governor invited Bharatiya Janata Party without any reason and rhyme, without even establishing whether they have more than 104 or not. And another most astonishing thing in the history of Indian democracy, no governor in the history of independent India has given any chief minister 2 weeks to prove the majority. The maximum time given to the chief minister, which I was also given, in Jammu Kashmir is the maximum 1 week. There are instances like in UP, Jagdishpal Pal was given 24 hours, just one day and one night. In number of cases, the chief ministers were given 2 to 3 days to prove the majority. But the maximum recorded history is 7 days. But here in Karnataka, a political party not having majority, the governor sahab gave him 15 days. That means deliberately 15 days were given to break the political parties. It's most unfortunate that the head of the state, the savior of the constitution, himself is violating the constitution to throttle the democracy. Now I would like to welcome the judgment of the Supreme Court. We had no other option but to approach Supreme Court. As I said in the beginning, that once again the highest court of the country has rose to the occasion, like they rose to the occasion when this BJP government, central government, toppled our government in Meghalaya, in Arunachal Pradesh, having 2/3 majority, rather 3/4 majority. The Supreme Court rose to the occasion and undid what the governor had done. And the High Court of Uttarakhand also did not go by the dictation of the central government and the government of India. So here we welcome the decision of the Supreme Court. Of course, our expectation was that court might even go beyond that and undo the decision of the Honorable Governor. But yet, whatever decision the Honorable Supreme Court has taken, we welcome this. We congratulate our judiciary for their uprightness, for saving the democracy, and for protecting the Constitution of India. The highlights of the judgment are three or four. Number one, the newly sworn in Chief Minister will not take any policy decision. So he has been barred from taking any policy decision till he proves his majority. The another decision the Supreme Court has taken, he cannot appoint any MLA. I think there is, government has already done. So that means the Supreme Court has undone that. Then the Supreme Court has said that the first thing is to appoint a pro-term speaker, and the MLA should be sworn in, and after swearing in ceremony of all the MLAs takes place, then from 4 o'clock tomorrow the process of confidence winning should start. So these are the major 4 things. Now we request that the pro-term speaker should be the senior most speaker, senior most legislature. This is customary across the country, and I being in parliament and assemblies both for 40 years, my colleagues here are more than 50 years, like our Kharge ji.
Not 50, 47 years.
47, very close to that. You have some more years to go, you will complete 50 also. The senior most legislature is the proter. So that is number one. We further demand. And the election of the speaker, which generally takes place, and not generally, always immediately after swearing in, the speaker is elected, the full-fledged speaker, and under his, the duly elected speaker, the whole procedure of confidence winning or no confidence winning takes place. Thank you very much. हम सुप्रीम कोर्ट के निर्णय का स्वागत करते हैं. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने एक दफा फिर ये बता दिया कि सरकार, केंद्रीय सरकार धांधली नहीं कर सकती. जिस तरह की धांधली केंद्रीय सरकार ने अपने गवर्नरों के द्वारा अरुणाचल प्रदेश में की थी, उत्तराखंड में की थी, बाद में गोवा, मणिपुर, मेघालय में की थी,
इन बिहार,
बिहार में की थी, और तब भी दो तीन दफा सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने और हाई कोर्ट ने इंटरवीन किया था, और एक आध गवर्नर के बारे में तो उन्होंने बहुत स्ट्रांग शब्दों का इस्तेमाल भी किया था. लेकिन भारतीय जनता पार्टी केंद्रीय सरकार का चमड़ा इतना मोटा है कि उसको सुप्रीम कोर्ट की फटकार का कोई असर नहीं पड़ता. उसके बाद भी वो बार बार वही गलतियां करते हैं जिसको सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने या हाई कोर्टों ने उन्हें मना किया है करने से. एक दफा सुप्रीम कोर्ट के जजों का हम स्वागत करते हैं, उनको सल्यूट करते हैं, पूरा देश उनको सल्यूट करता है. एक दफा केंद्रीय सरकार की मनमानी और माननीय गवर्नरों की मनमानी को उन्होंने रद्द कर दिया और संविधान को बचाया और भारत के लोकतंत्र को बचाने का प्रयास किया.
He has been in touch with the party.
My friend.
Not with
yeah,
me.
Yeah, I have entertained that. Yes. 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 Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. हमें ये भी आप किसी, लेकिन हमें मालूम है किस मंत्री के द्वारा से उनको फोन भी किया, बुलाया भी गया और बाद में पकड़ के ही रखा. ये सब चीजें बाद में होंगी, लेकिन हम आपको इतना बनाना चाहते हैं, हमारे पास कई एमएलएज की रिकॉर्डिंग है, हम उसको बताना नहीं चाहते, और उन लोगों की रिकॉर्डिंग है जो 5,000 या 35,000 के केस में अंदर थे, वो बाहर इसीलिए उन्होंने छोड़ा है ये काम करने के लिए, उनकी भी रिकॉर्डिंग. तो आप अंदाजा लगा सकते हैं किस तरीके का राजनीति केंद्रीय सरकार, जो जेल में होने चाहिए थे उनको टिकटें देते हैं और बाद में एमएलए दूसरी पार्टी के विपक्ष के खरीदने के लिए इस्तेमाल करते हैं.